रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताय पतये नमः। उत्तरकांड चैप्टर नंबर 26 रावण एंड किंग मंदात। रेसिटेशन बिगिंस नाउ। Having spent the night on the picturesque summit of Mount Meru and thinking for some time, the powerful lord of Lanka went to the region of the moon, and he saw a person proceeding, seated on a car sprinkled with heavenly unguents and attended upon by apsaras. And worn out with the satisfaction of desire, he was being kissed there. Seeing such a person, his curiosity was greatly excited. And beholding a rishi there, he said to him, "Welcome thou, O celestial saint. Indeed, thou hast come at a proper season. Who is this shameless wight that is going seated on a car and attended by apsaras? Does he not perceive his object of fear?" Being thus addressed by Ravana, Parvata Muni said, "My child, O thou gifted with great intellect, here I shall describe to thee the truth. By him all the worlds have been conquered and Brahma hath been propitiated, and he is now proceeding to that excellent region full of bliss for obtaining final liberation. As all the worlds have been conquered by thee by virtue of their asceticism, O Lord of Rakshasas, so he is going undoubtedly performing many pious actions and drinking soma juice. O foremost of Rakshasas, thou art heroic and hast truth for thy prowess. The powerful are never offended with the pious." Thereupon he saw an excellent huge car filled with all radiance and effulgence and the sound of musical instruments and singing. And Ravana said, "O great Rishi, who is that person gifted with great effulgence who goeth surrounded by charming songsters, dancing girls and kinnaras?" Hearing his words, Parvata, the foremost of saints, again said, "He is heroic and a great warrior. He never returneth unsuccessful from a battlefield. Having performed many heroic feats in battle and slain many enemies, he hath been assailed with many wounds in fighting and hath renounced his life for his master. Having destroyed many in battle, he hath at last been slain by his enemies and is perhaps now going either to the region of Indra or to some such place. This best of men is now being entertained by these well versed in the art of singing and dancing." Ravana said again, "Who goeth there effulgent like unto the sun?" Hearing the words of Ravana, Parvata said, "The person resembling the full moon and wearing divers ornaments and clothes, whom thou beholdest, O great king, in the golden car abounding in apsaras, distributed gold, he, gifted with great effulgence, is now going in a swift coursing car." Hearing the words of Parvata, Ravana said, "O foremost of rishis, do thou tell me who of these kings going, if prayed for, may offer me the hospitality of a battle? Forsooth, thou art my father. Do thou point out such a man to me, O thou conversant with piety." Being thus addressed, Parvata again said to Ravana, "O great king, all these kings wish for heaven, not for battle. I shall point out such a man, O great one, as shall enter into conflict with thee. There is a highly powerful king, the lord of the seven islands, well known by the name of Mandhata. He shall enter into an encounter with thee." Hearing the words of Parvata, Ravana said again, "Do thou tell me, O thou of great devotion, where this king resides? I shall go where lives this foremost of men." Hearing the words of Ravana, the sage said again, "The son of Yuvanashva had conquered the world consisting of seven islands beginning with the sea. Mandhata, the foremost of kings, is just coming to meet him." Thereupon, Ravana, having long arms, proud of the boon conferred upon him in the three worlds, beheld the heroic Mandhata, the lord of Ayodhya and the foremost of kings. The king of seven islands proceeded in a golden and well-painted car, resplendent like that of Mahendra, shining in his beauty and sprinkled with celestial unguents. The ten-headed demon said to him, "Do thou give me battle." Being thus addressed, he laughingly said to Dashgriva, "If thy life is not dear unto thee, do thou fight with me, O Rakshasa." Hearing the words of King Mahadatta, Ravana said, "Ravana did not experience any affliction from Varuna, Kubera, or Yama. Why should he experience any fear from thee, who art but a man?" Having said this, the Lord of Rakshasas, as if burning in ire, ordered the Rakshasas irrepressible in battle. Thereupon, the ministers of the vicious-souled Ravana, highly enraged and well-skilled in warfare, began to make a downpour of arrows. But before they had approached him, that foremost of men shattered them into pieces. Like unto fire burning down grass, the host of Rakshasas were burnt down by the King Mahadatta by means of hundreds of Bhushundis, Vallas, Vindipalas, and Tomaras. As Kartikeya, the son of fire, sundered the Mount Krauncha with his shafts, so did Mahadatta, enraged, pierce Prahasta with 5 Tomaras gifted with great velocity. Then hurling his mace again and again, resembling that of Yama, he struck vehemently Ravana's car therewith. That club, resembling the lightning, vehemently descended upon Ravana's car, and Ravana, like Chakra's banner, was speedily upset by that. Like unto the rising of the waters of the salt ocean on the full moon, the King Mahadatta's joy and strength were greatly increased. Thereupon, the entire Rakshasa host, emitting loud cries, stood encircling on all sides the Lord of Rakshasas. Thereat, speedily regaining his sense, Ravana, a terror unto all people, the Lord of Lanka, greatly assailed the person of Mahadatta. And beholding that king in a swoon, the highly powerful night rangers were greatly delighted and emitted leonine roars. Regaining his sense in a moment, the king of Ayodhya beheld his enemy, worshipped by the courtiers and the night rangers. He was instantly worked up with ire, and assuming a person resplendent like that of the sun and the moon, he began to slay the Rakshasa host with a dreadful downpour of shafts. With his arrows and the noise thereof, the entire Rakshasa army were overwhelmed like the agitated deep. Thereupon there arose a dreadful conflict between men and demons, and those two heroic, high-souled and foremost of men and Rakshasas, seated on warrior's seats and holding bow and daggers, entered the field. And possessed by great anger, they began to assail one another with shafts, Mahadatta, Ravana, and he again the king. They being assailed by one another were both wounded, and setting the Raudra shaft upon his bow, Ravana discharged it, but Mahadatta baffled it by means of his fiery arrows. The 10-necked demon took up the Gandharva weapon, and the king Mahadatta the Brahmastra weapon, striking terror unto all. Ravana then took up the celestial Pashupata weapon, dreadful and increasing the fright of the three worlds, obtained by him from Rudra by virtue of his rigid penances. Seeing this, all animals, mobile and immobile, were stricken with terror. Thereupon trembled all the three worlds consisting of mobile and immobile beings. The celestials and all the serpents became inert. Being apprised of this conflict by virtue of meditation, the two foremost of ascetics, Pulisthya and Galava, remonstrated with them in many a way and prevented the King Mahadatta and the foremost of Rakshasas. Thereupon, that man and demon, being reconciled with one another, went back by the ways they had respectively came. Mangalam Kushalendraya Mahaniya Gunabdeya Chakravarti Dharmajaya Sarva Bhomaya Mangalam.